Hello, everybody. Now, Robin, Madeleine's first grandchild, who she loved dearly, is going to bring up a book. It's called You Are My Sunshine. And this is what Madeleine said to Robin lots of times. Christian, her grandson, that she also loved very dearly, he's a candle for her, a guardian candle, burning bright, watch over us all tonight. And then Imogen, who's our own little character, Granny loved her, and she's given a teddy bear, her bunny teddy. And then Amelia, her last grandchild, our child, is bringing up some flowers from Granny's garden, because Granny loved her garden. And lastly, Carmel, one of our great friends who had lots of great chats together, is bringing her up a candle, because the ladies always were burning candles for people that needed them.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the Lord be with you. You're all very welcome to our church this morning for the funeral mass for Madeleine Kinsley. Welcome Austin, and also Gillian and Greg, also Laura and her grandchildren Robin, Christian, Imogen and Amelia, who have already brought forward her gifts, and all those of you who are members of the extended family and friends of Madeleine. May her soul and the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest. You are sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You plead for us with the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. O God, who are mercy for sinners and the happiness of your saints, give, we pray, to your servant Madeleine Kinsella, for whom we perform the fraternal offices of burial, a share with your chosen ones in the blessedness you give, so that on the day of resurrection, freed from the bonds of mortality, she may come before your face. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. Now Mag is going to read our first scripture.
A reading from the prophet Isaiah. On this mountain, the Lord of hosts will prepare for all peoples a banquet of rich food. On this mountain, he will remove the mourning veil covering all peoples, and a shroud enwrapping all nations. He will destroy debt forever. The Lord will wipe away the tears from every cheek. He will take away people's shame everywhere on earth, for the Lord has said so. That day it will be said, "See, this is our God in whom we hoped for salvation. The Lord is the one in whom we hoped. We exult and we rejoice that he has saved us." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I'm A reading from the letter of St. Paul to Timothy. My life is already being poured away, and the time has come for me to be gone. I have fought the good fight to the end. I have run the race to the finish. I have kept the faith. All there is to come now is the crown of righteousness reserved for me, which the Lord, the righteous judge, will give to me on that day, and not only to me, but to all of those who have longed for his coming. The Lord stood by me and gave me power, so that through me the whole message might be proclaimed for all to hear. And so I was rescued from the lion's mouth. The Lord will rescue me from all evil attempts on me and bring me safely to his heavenly kingdom. To him be glory forever and ever. Amen. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. Trust in God still and trust in me. There are many rooms in my Father's house. If there were not, I should have told you. I am going now to prepare a place for you. And after I have gone and prepared you a place, I shall return to take you with me, so that where I am, you may be too. You know the way to the place where I am going." Thomas said, "Lord, we do not know where you are going, so how can we know the way?" Jesus said, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one can come to the Father except through me." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Please be seated for a moment. The death of someone we love, especially when it's not expected, comes as a profound shock. The physical separation can feel incredibly final. Throughout human history, death has been a mystery that we've tried to unravel. Countless books, philosophies, songs have been written, all grappling with the concept of death, wanting to offer some kind of understanding, some kind of comfort in the face of what appears to be the ultimate end. I believe the best answer to this question is to see the life of a person who has lived serving and loving the other, with looking to their eternal home. Today, we gather to celebrate and remember the life of Madeleine. By all accounts, a remarkable lady. She touched the hearts of everyone she met in a unique way. And in moments like this, we find ourselves reflecting on the beauty of life and the connections that we share with each other. Madeleine was a source of joy and love for you in your life. Her caring nature, her kindness, her unwavering support for the family, have all left a lasting impact on your life. Today, as we share the memories of Madeleine, let us honour the love and the warmth that these memories bring into our life. In our grief, let us find consolation in our faith. We heard in the gospel, do not let your hearts be troubled. Trust in God. Madeleine came to this church because she trusted in God. She trusted in God even when there was times she didn't fully understand the events that was happening. She still trusted in God. And as we heard in the first reading, the veil has now been removed for Madeleine. And she sees the face of God. And she understands that everything that happened in her life, all the events, were guided by love. This love, this unconditional love that God has for all of us. Madeleine now sees this clearly. During these days, this time, let us lean on each other and on the faith of the church. As you pass through these difficult days and we remember Madeleine, let us commit to carrying her forward, her spirit of love and generosity to all those we meet. Let us honour her, not just in words today, but in our life as we go forward. Let us strive to commit to bring what she believed in to others, to keep this memory alive, taking comfort knowing that Madeleine is now embraced by love and surrounded by eternal life, light. And may her memory be a blessing and a guide to us as we continue on our journey to our eternal home, where there is no more sorrow, no more tears, no more separation. Until then, let us entrust Madeleine to the loving arms of our Father. Eternal rest grant unto Madeleine, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon her. May her soul rest in peace. Please stand now, and we pray for Madeleine today. And leading us in our prayer is Laura, Robin, Christian, and Imogen. Almighty God and loving Father, we know that you listen to the prayers of the humble. We ask you now, as we present to you our deep petitions.
We pray for Madeleine's family, friends, and all those who cared for her. May she continue to inspire us, guide us, and be there at the end to welcome us in our turn into eternal life. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for all our departed relatives and friends. May Granny Madeleine be reunited with them in God's kingdom, where there is no more pain or suffering. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For all those who cared for Granny in hospital, may God bless them and reward them for their kindness and care. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for all those who are ill. May God's strength and healing be with them. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We present these prayers and the prayers that's in our heart through the intercession of Mary, our mother, as we say together, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. So please be seated while we have the offertory of the Mass. And Greg and Gillian will bring up the gifts of bread and wine.
Summons that we come to birth, by your will that we are governed, and at your command that we return on account of sin to that earth from which we came. And when you give the sign, we who have been redeemed by the death of your Son shall be raised up to the glory of his resurrection. So with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praises without end we attain. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts. Heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of God. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat out of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when the supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Save us, Saviour of the world, for by our cross and resurrection you have set us free. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of church, together with Francis, our Pope, Dermot, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servant, Madeline Kinsland, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she, who was united with your Son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray. That with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, the Blessed Apostle, St. Dominic, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honour is yours, forever and ever. Amen. At the Saviour's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, power, and
glory, Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign for ever and ever. And the peace of the Lord be with you all. Let's offer each other a gesture of that peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Where to begin to celebrate a life so full? It says, a eulogy is a writing of high praise for one deceased. So the challenge before us in writing these words for an amazing mum was not to think of material, but rather to whittle it down to a reasonable length of time. I could have us here until the sun goes down without any fear of running out of stories. Our precious mum had so many good qualities and touched so many people that I would like you to think of these words as a synopsis on the back cover of Mum's Book of Life. A book that would surely make the Book of Kells look like a pamphlet by comparison. I see so many people around me that could have whole chapters dedicated to them. The large congregation I see before me today comes as no surprise, as to know my mum was to love her. You couldn't be fooled by her diminutive stature, because inside her lived the most massive personality and biggest heart you could ever hope to find. The most beautiful of souls, an absolute force of nature, her distinctive laugh would fill the air, and her gentle smile could melt even the coldest of hearts. Even those that had the briefest of encounters with her on their own life's journey would have admiration for her. But those closest to her were the luckiest of all. Her mark so ingrained in us that we'll carry it with us forever and it will never fade. Mum was the youngest of six children, the baby of the family, and was brought up among some amazing neighbours in Tenney Road. Some of you may know that her first name is actually Bridget, after her mother, for whom she had the utmost admiration and respect. Having lost her father only 3 years old, a heavy burden was placed upon her mother. But she worked her fingers to the bone to provide for her family, working two and three jobs to keep a roof over their heads and food on the table. And that's something that Mum never forgot. Just as myself and Jill will never forget all that Mum did for us. Not only was she a provider, she picked us up when we were down. She was our shoulder to cry on. Her comfort when it seemed the world was against us. She put us on a pedestal. I was so very proud of us. She used to say to me, "Son, you could go anywhere with your head held high." And I promise you that I will hold my head high, Mum, but not born of self-confidence, but with the pride I have instilled in me that I could call you my Mum. When God was assigning parents, myself and Jill won the cosmic lottery. I know of no other parents as wonderful as ours. Mum met my dad and my Uncle Liam's motorbike shop in Harold's Cross, and it seemed that the latest Greaves or Motor Guzzi were the only thing that caught my dad's eye in the shop. Motorcycles would feature heavily in all of our lives, but more on that later. What Dad lacked in his wooing capabilities, he more than made up for in his persistence. He had the engagement ring thrown back at him 13 times. But as the old saying goes, the 14th time's the charm. I think that's how it goes anyway. But thank you, Dad, from the bottom of my heart, that you are so determined, and when you decide you need something, you won't rest until you have it. A quality that I know I haven't heard of myself. If you'd given up more easily, myself and Jill would have never existed, at least not in this wonderful version of life that you've given us. Mum knew that love wasn't something that you're given a finite amount of when you're born, a reserve that has to be weaned out in small doses. She knew that a love given could grow exponentially and spread, much like a virus, only the good kind. A more compassionate person you couldn't meet, wherever a family member or friend was in need, there she was, right in the middle of it, propping everyone up around her. I swear she was like Ireland's answer to Mother Teresa sometimes. When she was in her greatest hour of need last Friday, I reminded her of all the souls that she cared for that were embarking on their final journey, and that she need not worry, that they'll take her hand and lead her willingly into heaven. We look around us today, and we see all of the people here that are helping Mum on her journey, but not to say goodbye, but to see you again someday. I know that there's at least as many more on the other side to welcome her with open arms. They missed her too much and took her back just a little bit too early. I'll be sure to give them a piece of my mind when I see them. Well, my Mum did something, anything for that matter. She was all in. She loved deeply, praised highly, and cared completely. That's why whenever Dad or Jill wanted to do something, she was behind us 100%. Starting with Dad, he decided that he was fairly handy at this motorcycle racing lark. And so began a fantastic career, or better still, life in racing. So many fantastic lifelong friends gathered along the way, like picking the most beautiful flowers as they walked through their meadow of life. John and Helen, Phyllis, Ryan, Betty, Ken and Babs, John and Kathleen, Leo and Etna. The list goes on and on. They travel the length and breadth of the country, and the continent for that matter, sharing the thrills and spills of racing. Thousands of stories and millions of laughs along the way. Bonds that were formed, perhaps even stronger, because of the danger of the sport they were involved in, where it was commonplace for friends to roll out of the paddock and sadly never come back. But those involved in racing, those not involved in racing could never understand the camaraderie but there are many in this room that know exactly what I'm talking about. After embarking on an illustrious career in racing with Dad, it was then the turn of myself and Jill. I know for a fact that parts of Mrs. Doyle's character were based on my mum. She fed half the paddock and kept Lion's Tea in business for decades with countless cups of tea. A friend of mine reminded me the other day of a funny story from when we were at a grass track in Ockham many years ago. There we all were in the back of our van, the social focal point of any paddock, eating sandwiches and drinking tea, having a crack. Suddenly, there was a furore. Our race is on. The race officials were on the grid, throwing their hands in the air, wondering where literally half of the grid was. As the race started, all of our gang were jumping out of the back of the van, throwing our helmets and gloves on, and hopping on our bikes, still with half a mouthful of Auntie Madge's ham and cheese sambo in our mouth. They were literally the best of times. I will forever be thankful for the sacrifices and hard work that Mum and Dad had to put in to give us all these memories. A few short years later, when I turned my attention to supermodel, Mum's reputation spread even farther and wider, not only in Ireland, but all over the UK and Europe. She'd gone international again. All the weekends travelling thousands of miles of motorway, track to track, and Mum, Dad and Jill are so special to me. Mum used to say to me just before getting on the bike, "Mind yourself, son, and take your time." I laughed at her at the time, of course, because in my mind, racing was all about not taking her time. On reflection, I was the one who had it wrong all along, that the racing was never really about the results. It was about the amazing memories. Jill was a talented footballer, as well as a motorcyclist. And as you would expect, there was Mum with her at her side every match, on the sideline, shouting encouragement, willing the whole team on. Sometimes her passion would get the better of her, and rumour has it that she may have been escorted off the sideline by disgruntled referees on a few occasions, but that's just a rumour. The word legend is bandied about too much these days and perhaps has lost some of its meaning, but Mrs. K, as she was affectionately known by all the girls in the team, was a legend in the true sense of the word, and I'm sure they would agree. Mum had a very close circle of friends and family with whom she was particularly close. Mag, Lily and Kathleen, Helen, Phyllis and Carmel. You were all so precious to Mum, and she would speak of you with such warmth and kindness. They would spend countless hours on the phone, fixing all the world's problems, and when they got together, they consumed enough tea to fill Blessing and Legs 100 times over. If anyone here has shares in telecoms or tea companies, I suggest that you use this insider information and ditch them before the bottom falls out of the market next week. Mum's grandchildren, Robin, Christian, Imogen and Amelia, were the light of her life. If she could have given them the sun, moon and stars, she would have. And sometimes she would arrive with her there with so many bags of clothes and gifts, I thought she may just have brought the sun, moon and stars with her. She idolised each and every one of them and was so proud of them. Robin, so gentle and full of grace. It was like all Mum's Christmases had come at once when you arrived, and she relished the opportunity to become a mammy all over again, only this time it was a grand mammy. Christian, her special little man, and her only grandson. I know that Mum looked at you the same way that she did me, and I hope you remember that and cherish it. Imogen, personality as big as Mum's already, and she's only 8 years old. The future holds wonderful things for you. And Amelia, her precious little mischief maker, with a smile that would melt your heart, a kiss and a squeeze from you is the best medicine that Mum ever got. Mum loved every hair in your heads and every fibre of your being. Know that you have the most special of guardian angels looking over you. Every step of the way, every beat of your heart, take comfort in knowing that your granny is taking care of you. Laura, my mum loved you every bit as much as she did myself and Jill. When she spoke you, she literally glowed. Every day, You will remind me of Mum, because you're her all over. Every bar of her, as she'd say. You're such a wonderful mammy. And just as wonderful a person. I know you'll help us through this most difficult time. Mum's left behind the biggest pair of tiny size 3 shoes ever known. But I know you'll step into them. I always knew that Mum was more concerned about other people than she was for herself, and this was confirmed to me last Friday. Having been only given a couple of hours, Mum was clinging on for us, as we all spoke to her and told her how much we loved her. Nearly 10 hours later, when I got a moment alone in the room with her, I told her not to be afraid. I promised her that I would look after Dad and Jill, and we'd look after each other. A few short minutes later, she slipped away. As peacefully as any gentle soul could hope for. She wouldn't go until she knew we were all safe. But her watch was over, and now she could rest. Mum's absence will leave a huge hole deep inside so many of us. But if I know her at all, I know that she'll leave us all a piece of her behind to help us get through. Some of us will need a bigger piece than others, but God will know how to distribute them so we all get a piece just the right size. Make sure you give your piece back to her when you make your own journey to meet her again, and she will welcome you with open arms and the warmest hug you'll ever get. We love you so much, Mum. I hope we can make you so proud. Till we see you again. All our love.
Please stand for the final commendation. Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our sister. May our farewell express our affection for her. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day, we shall joyfully greet her again when the love of Christ destroys even death itself. Into your hands, Father of Mercy, we commend our sister, Madeline. in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon Madeline in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn towards us and listen to our prayer. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and we are with you and with our sister forever. Amen. Madeline, may the angels lead you into paradise and the martyrs come to welcome you and take you to the holy city, the new and eternal Jerusalem. In peace, let us take our sister to her place of rest. Thank you.